fans, and welcome to another episode of Silver Screams Reacts. We have the new-ish, it came out a couple days ago, Alien Covenant trailer, and I am so excited for this because the Last Supper video was actually pretty solid, So I'm really looking forward to this next trailer.
Alright, let's just do it then.
Hopefully we get a little bit more xenomorph action this time around, but I don't want them to show too much.
You've all sacrificed so much to be here.
Damn it, I knew it was just a clip from the movie. That's true.
This crew is made up of couples.
Yeah.
It's the first large scale
happy couples
mission
that are gonna live long, fulfilling lives.
I'm really grateful for your hard work.
Honey.
Your courage.
Couples and one
whatever face covers.
One robot. Well, because I imagine
other robot.
They picked an atmosphere that, like, humans could live on.
What are the odds of finding this far from Earth?
Who planted it?
People planted wheat before they got there?
You hear that?
What?
Nothing. No birds. No animals. Nothing.
That's eerie. That's a problem. Plot twist, they're actually on the pitch black planet. That one's a desert.
The path to paradise.
Oh, yes.
What happened here?
Begins.
Someone's dog tagged it in there?
Well, they also showed the ship from Prometheus. Oh, friend, why are none of you wearing face coverings?
Oh, honey.
In hell.
Close up on the vagina face.
What's happening?
No one knows.
Captain, just calm down, sir. Calm down.
Tell me to calm down.
You're breaking up.
Oh, yeah.
All of this to start our new life.
It's behind you!
Let me out!
Wow!
Holy
shit! Oh, man! Dude!
Wow!
I can't tell if that's showing too much of the alien or not, but man, like,
I don't think it is. I think it's more of a, here is what we are now capable of in terms of technology and visual effects.
It looks so good. Like, on the, because that's the thing that always made the xenomorph a really great monster was because you were always seeing it from the shadows. It was always striking, and then people would be dead off screen, and like it was the omnipresent fear of it being around. But like, and then we got Aliens, which was the more action movie oriented, which had a little bit of that, but there was a little bit more action, but you're still dealing with a lot of prosthetic limitations with CGI.
We know, and the other thing is, this is a legacy thing.
Yeah.
We know what this is. We know what it's capable of. Game over, man. Game over is part of our cultural lexicon.
Oh, Bill Paxton.
Yeah. But, you know, in space, no one can hear you scream.
Yeah.
So many things from this franchise are part of our cultural lexicon. They are cultural cornerstones. And so at this point, you don't really have to establish a xenomorph. We know what they are. We know what they can do. Now they're taking that and they are just sprinting with it.
And just from the kind of little bits that we saw, the more kind of fleshy colored bit, and there's a thumbnail with a video talking about like theory of the evolution of the xenomorph that we're looking at right now. But yeah, that does look like a step from what we saw in Prometheus to, like, I imagine the fleshy thing and then to a full-on xenomorph, which is super
creepy.
Exciting and also really cool to get to see that, if the movie decides to go that route, to see that evolution within the film.
Excuse me, and we saw the ship from Prometheus sitting there like it had been there for a good chunk
of
time. And we someone's dog tags, which I think were from Prometheus.
The thing is that Prometheus, she flew, like, the ship crashed, and then, yeah, we get that.
And then we got the Prometheus school of running away from things.
And, which was so stupid. and then so we get, you know, the xenomorph popping, popping out of the engineer at the end of that movie, and I guess that we're meant to infer that then this thing then laid a bunch of eggs, and, or, yeah, we don't know how much time has passed. What I assume this is the planet that Prometheus was located on?
That but was heavily implied.
Who grew the wheat? Was that something in Prometheus that I don't at all remember?
I wonder if it was something that got scattered when something happened, and then it just seeded.
It might also be just a completely different ship. Like, because Prometheus answered Prometheus answered no questions and took place at a completely different location than everybody was anticipating, because Alien took place on a particular planet before they went back into space, and everybody was anticipating that Prometheus, that at the end, the space jockey would fly off to that planet, and then the xenomorph would pop out, and all of a sudden things would be connected. But they weren't, for some reason. Because of reasons? I guess because we really wanted Prometheus Part 2. But yeah, the main character from Prometheus flew off with David's head. So we still don't know what became of her, so I wonder if she'll make an appearance at some point, or whatever, like a log saying whatever happened to her. Because she was determined to go and meet the engineers, so whether or not an engineer is going to pop back up on this planet, or maybe she came back when she couldn't find answers and just decided to make a life for herself, I don't know.
Who knows?
Yeah, but somebody planted wheat, and that's real weird. Who knows? All in all, though, this looks freaking awesome. It does. It looks so good, but I've been hurt before.
You have fun.
I've been hurt before, Katie. I don't know what to do.
And yet you keep going back to horror movie sequels and prequels.
Yeah.
Because that's all we get right now. Except for the indie scene.
Except for Get Out. Yeah, Get Out was real good, guys. If you haven't seen it, go see it. I suppose I'll talk about that another time. This looks great, and I'm excited.
Yeah.
Any chance you'd want to go?
Hell no.
Xenomorph will haunt your dreams.
Hell no.
Well,
was that frightened 10-year-old girl who screamed at the Xenomorph in the Great Movie Ride in Disney World.
Which is so cool! It's so much fun! Really good animatronics.
Only person in the car who screamed. Mom's looking at me like, are you serious? I'm like,
yes. To be fair, they've blended in very well with the shadows.
They also show the trailer for it in the waiting room. He's not handling that
well. Boo!
I'm not taking it super well.
Anyway, before, hopefully you won't have any nightmares about this, but in the meantime, where can people go if they want to keep up with you?
All over the internets and the YouTube at Kiaxet, that is K-I-A-X-E-T. If you like non-horror reaction videos, that's where those live.
Yep. For anybody who doesn't like horror things for some reason, I don't know who that would be. Anyway, I'm Megan. You guys can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at TheMenguin. That's TheMenguin.
I'm sorry, I love you. You're a good friend.
We're putting up with all this.
Finish your sign off.
Be sure to follow Silver Screams at @silver_screams. Like us on Facebook, all that jazz. I want to know what you guys think about this. And I also want to know, what would be your ideal alien movie? Because we've gotten a handful, and some of them are great, and some of them are not so much. So I want to know, what is the premise for your ideal alien movie?
And I want to know, what's a horror sci-fi prequel that hasn't disappointed you?
How many of those are there?
Exactly. Which is why it's subjective.
Yeah, fair enough. Well, anyway, thank you guys so, so much for watching. We'll see you all next time.